Hi, everyone. I'm Laura. I'm a veterinarian currently pursuing a PhD in epidemiology, and I study wildlife health. Now, you might be asking yourselves, why study wildlife health? And there are three main reasons I'm going to tell you about, all of which have to do with the concept of one health, which posits that the health of humans, animals, and the environment is linked. For example, did you know that 75% of emerging infectious diseases in people come from animals? Of these, about 60% involve wildlife, and that includes things like Ebola virus and SARS. So the first reason to study wildlife health is for human health. The second reason to study wildlife health is for food safety. Just like people, our food-producing species can also get diseases from wildlife, including things like avian influenza and foot and mouth disease. So to protect our food supply, it's important to know what diseases are circulating in wildlife. The third reason to study wildlife health, and this is the one that I'm most interested in, is for conservation. Current extinction rates are about 100 to 1,000 times higher than they used to be, and unfortunately, this is due mostly to human activities. As wildlife populations become more and more stressed from human-induced environmental changes, the effects of disease on their overall survival become more important. You might have heard of white-nose syndrome in bats or chytrid fungus in amphibians. And these are just two examples of diseases that are associated with significant population declines, and in some cases, even extinctions. So to protect biodiversity on our planet, it's important to understand wildlife health. Now, historically, previous studies into the health of threatened and endangered species tended to focus on the effects of one disease in one population at one time point. This is problematic because wildlife disease or wildlife health is complex and dynamic, and populations and their pathogens don't exist in a vacuum. In other words, if you try to look at health with too narrow of a focus, you miss the big picture. And so what we really need are more comprehensive approaches to wildlife health assessment that account for natural variability between populations and that look at the effects of more than one disease at a time. And that's where I come in. So my study species is the very charismatic Eastern box turtle, and I'm studying the effects of environmental factors and over 20 different infectious diseases on the health of 6 box turtle populations over the course of 3 years. I'm also evaluating the use of multiple different diagnostic tests to get a really complete picture of health in this species. Once I'm done with my field data, I'm going to use it to generate a mathematical model that helps me identify the most important causes of poor health in box turtles and the most clinically useful diagnostic tests for health assessment in this species. This allows me to generate targeted, evidence-based conservation strategies that are specifically tailored to the needs of box turtles. My ultimate goal is for this framework I'm building to be applied to other threatened and endangered species to improve conservation outcomes globally. So that's me, combining math, science, and medicine to save the world, one turtle at a time. Thank you.